Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will be demonstrating how to manage your documents in BoldSign. Before exploring BoldSign's document management options, let us look at the various document statuses available. Waiting for me indicates that the document is waiting for you to sign. Waiting for others, the document is waiting for other recipients to sign. Needs attention, documents that fail to deliver because of an invalid email address and require further action. Completed, all recipients have signed the document and no further action is needed. Declined, the signer has declined to sign the document. Expired, the signer didn't sign the document before the deadline. Revoked, the document sender has chosen to recall or cancel it. Let's explore the document managing options now. On the BoldSign dashboard page, all documents are arranged according to their status. This is helpful in checking the documents based on the status quickly. The waiting for me, waiting for others, and needs attention statuses are arranged in separate columns, while revoked, declined, and completed are in one column. To know the details of any document, simply click on it. This will open the document's overview page, where you will find all the information. To view all your documents, navigate to My Documents page. This page displays all the documents sent by you, received by you, and added as CC. When hovering on the document status, information like document ID, timestamps, recipient details, etc. is displayed in a tooltip. When I click the document, you can see the entire details in the document's overview page. When hovering over a document, you will see the Quick Action button at the end. You can perform necessary actions quickly using this button. This button varies according to the status of the document. Let's say you sent a signature request that is not yet signed by the recipient, and it is in the Waiting for Others status. In that case, the Send Reminder button will be the Quick Action button. Just click it and add a reminder message and send it directly to the recipient. In the Waiting for Me document, Sign Now will be the Quick Action button. Similarly, you can perform quick actions on other documents too. Next to the Quick Action button, you'll see a Context Menu button. The Context Menu options will also change based on the status of the document. The Context Menu for the Waiting for Others contains adding tags, viewing, downloading, cloning, sending reminders and revoking the document. Suppose you have sent a document to someone for their signature, but you later found that you've made a mistake, then you can use the Revoke option to cancel the document. I click the Revoke option button and enter the reason for revoking the document. This ensures that the document is not signed or accessed by anyone else. After revoking the document, if you want to send after editing it, instead of creating one from scratch, you can directly clone the revoked document. The clone option creates a copy of the revoked document. Then make the necessary changes to the cloned document and send the updated document. If you want to filter the documents in My Documents page based on the status, use the Quick Filters option, which is located at the top of the page. This Quick Filter option is helpful for filtering documents with a specific status. I click the Completed button to view all completed documents. See, the completed documents alone are displayed. Likewise, you can filter all statuses. Next, if you want to find a particular document with a piece of information, you can use the search box located above the quick filters. Search by entering a partial title, document ID, tags, sender name, or receiver name. Let me search by entering the word agreement. All the documents that have the word agreement in the title will be displayed. In addition, if you want to filter documents more specifically, you can use the Advanced Filter option. Here, I click the Advanced Filter button, located at the right corner of the search box. A pop-up with several options opens. By entering the required information in these fields, you can filter documents based on your specific needs. For example, I want to filter the completed documents related to onboarding and sent by me to the person named Alex Gale within this month. For this, first I choose Sent and select the status as completed. Sent by value is auto-filled with my name. In recipients, I choose Alex Gale and in tags I choose onboarding. Finally, the sent between date range should be this month. As you can see, when I click the Apply Filter button, all documents that match my search criteria are displayed. The filter I have created is displayed at the top of the page. Near that, there is a Clear All Filters option that allows you to clear the filter instantly. I can also pin the filter on the dashboard page for later use. I now click on that option and enter the widget name. And then I click on the Save and Pin option to save the filter on the dashboard page. So far, I have showed you document managing options. Next, let me show you how to organize the documents using tags. Tags are labels that can be assigned to documents, which makes it easier to find them later. You can add tags when you create a document or even after it is created. To add a tag, hover over a document, click on the context menu and select the Add Tag option. I enter the tag NDA. Once the tag is added, it will be visible under the document title. Any number of tags can be added to a single document, which will help in multi-level search. To filter documents based on tags, you can directly click on the tag and filter the documents. For example, if you want to filter documents with the NDA tag, click on the NDA tag, and all the documents that contain the NDA tag will be displayed. If you want to filter documents with multiple tags, click on the 2022 tag after clicking on the NDA tag. Only documents that contain both the NDA and 2022 tags will be displayed. This is an easy and efficient way to filter documents based on specific tags. Next, if you want to manage your team documents, you can navigate to the Team Documents page. This page contains all the documents related to team members and has options like those found on the My Documents page. Additionally, it has two advanced filters that allow you to filter based on a team or member. To filter documents for a specific team, simply select the team name from the All Teams option. Similarly, to filter documents for a specific member, enter the name in the All Members option. That's all about managing the documents. If you found this video useful, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe. Thank you for watching and stay tuned to our channel for more BoldSign tutorial videos.